little Sandy, where are we?
Some kind of island or archipelago.
Well, why?
The plane crashed.
The crash landed.
What?
A fireman has lifted you from the smoke and wreckage.
As I say, I've broken my arm, so I couldn't.
Just broke his arm because his train ticket was down.
Fell down.
Well, I don't remember at all. I think I must have blacked up.
Blacked out?
I mean, I remember a blast.
I said there was a blast.
We don't know what it was.
I'm pretty sure there was a blast.
I'm certain there was.
Light of the
last. We don't know.
Was it a bomb, do you think, Ian?
Well, this is it.
It wasn't a bomb.
The fuselage does look bomb damaged.
But where did it come from?
Well, who did it come from?
It could have just been the engine.
A bomb in the engine.
Was it a terrorist, Ian?
Probably not the possibility of a terrorist or terrorists.
Why would terrorists bring down a random passenger plane?
Why does anyone do anything?
What? I'm saying terrorists are assholes. Half the stuff they do doesn't make sense and... You know, post 9/11, anything can happen.
But that was into a building in a city.
Two buildings, technically.
This is the middle of nowhere.
Oh, well, we don't know what it is. It could be the middle of somewhere. Are we going to miss the conference?
Maybe.
Probably.
We might make the end.
Davidson will literally go ape.
What a shit hot excuse, to be fair.
But what we do? We're not there.
What do you think they'll do? They'll take credit for my work. Healy will say the data on debt obligations for millennials was hers. Carl won't say anything, the bloody weasel.
Don't call Carl a weasel, please!
He is a weasel!
Yes, that's racist!
What? How is that racist? He's not from anywhere!
He is, actually. He is from somewhere. As head of HR, I made a note of it.
The weasels aren't from anywhere either!
Oh, well, he always eats very smelly lunches, doesn't he?
Yeah, I think Carl's ancestors are American Indian.
I don't care where he's from! I'm saying he'll take credit for my work! They all will! Again!
Yes, Gus, we're all very angry about this, mate.
Me more than anyone.
Why? Why you more than anyone?
Well, because this whole conference was very much my baby.
Excuse me? Your baby?
As in, my idea.
Oh, of course, Ian. An international conference for 12 polling companies was your idea.
I mentioned the concept of Australia to Davidson. Yeah? He ran with it, fired off some emails, and now, here we are.
Well, not here. This is... I didn't suggest this. Really.
Fuck!
You maybe might delay it.
Yeah? No! I wasn't thinking about that. I just meant that...
The plane crash. Sure.
Typical. This always happens to me, these transport cock-ups. This is just my luck.
Everyone else is dead, Marie.
Yes. Well, what about the captain? Surely the captain's not dead.
Everyone's dead.
The captain's dead and then some, to be honest.
You saw him dead?
It's pretty grisly, actually. Holding his own head.
Oh, my God!
Sorry, I might have misled you a bit then, Marie. It was still on his neck. He just had it in his hands. He was essentially on a face. The whole cabin was covered in innards. It's like a bloody meat market.
Meat market means everyone's getting off with each other.
Look back then. It's like a bloody bath. It's gross.
And of course, it's out.
Is it Fitair who's dead?
Yes.
His name was Declan. He just got married.
Oh, well, lucky escape then.
Ian! Really, that is an awful thing to say.
Come on, it's just a joke.
Yeah, but it's not funny.
It's risque, maybe. I mean, otherwise this is all just a bit depressing, isn't it?
There's an argument for saying it should be depressing.
And I'm sure the vast majority of the coverage would be.
What coverage? Are we going to be on the news, Ian?
Probably not.
Definitely, this will be huge news.
Oh, well, that's exciting. I hope my family's taping it if I'm on the news.
They'll think you're dead.
Yeah.
Do you think somebody will find him? They might do, Stephanie.
We should bury him more deeply.
Yeah, we should call the police.
Why?
Because if they realise we've been back here and we didn't do anything, they'll probably realise we did it.
You did it.
Yeah.
It was nothing to do with me.
No.
I thought we were going to take him home.
Well, maybe it's best to just leave it then. It's probably better not to interfere. I think if we ignore it, it'll definitely go away. I can't believe we've not found him yet. They must be idiots. I like your shoes.
Thanks.
They're beautiful.
I got them second hand.
They were real fine.
They were cheap as well.
That's good.
30 quid.
Wicked. You all packed?
Yeah.
That's good.
Mum packed for me.
That's nice of her. I brought you this back. You should give it to Alex.
It's shit.
Dad got us an iPhone 4. It's much better. The apps are better. The screen's better. He's got the phone on it.
Brilliant.
We should bury this with him and then the police will trace it back to Alex and he'll have been framed.
I'm sorry about your mum.
What about her?
Oh, yeah. That's all right.
Thanks for apologising.
When's the funeral?
I don't think we're going to have a funeral.
We probably will.
I'll let you know.
You could come back for it.
I don't think I'll do that.
No.
How old do you think he looks?
I don't know.
Do you think they'll be able to recognise him if they do find him?
I think they probably will, Stephanie, yes.
Where do you think he looks like he comes from?
Not around here.
How can you tell?
I can't really. It's just a thought.
He looks fatter than I remember him being.
He's become bloated. It happens.
Look at those marks on his skin. I didn't make those marks.
They're from all the flies.
Flies? Flies from the earth eating their way inside him. Soon they'll lay eggs and little maggots will start crawling out of him. He doesn't look sad at all, does he?
No.
What do you think it felt like, being him?
I don't know.
Do you want some gin?
Yes, please.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, it doesn't even taste nice.
No.
I've noticed that for the past few days.
What?
Nothing tastes nice anymore. My clothes feel horrible. Every time I stand up, I feel heavy. I feel poor.
You're not poor.
No, but I feel it. What are you gonna do with that?
Sell it.
How much will you get for it, do you think?
Not much. £5 maybe? Probably ask for 10 and end up with 5.
Have the police interviewed you yet?
Twice. Once last night and again this morning.
They probably know it was you then, don't they? They're probably suspicious. You're probably their prime suspect.
I went round to see his mum.
Why?
I went round to ask her if he was in. I asked her if he wanted to come out. You should have seen her face. I could not stop giggling.
I'm still going. Don't think you stopped me from leaving because you haven't.
What makes you think I was trying to stop you from leaving? What time are you heading off?
In the morning.
That's taking a day off work.
They'll still find
you. They won't be looking for me. When they find you, are you going to tell them what happened?
No.
You better not.
I won't.
That's a promise.
Kathy, what are you doing here? I thought you were at work. I thought I was going to get some time to myself. Are you all right? You look like you've seen a ghost.
Why aren't you at work?
Well, Mr. Kirkby said I could leave early. Hey, I like your dress. I've not seen that before, have I?
I don't know. Do you know what I've only just noticed about you?
What?
Your aura.
My what?
It's a very unusual colour.
Is it? What is it?
Ruth, you must be able to see it. That's one of the things that babies can do. So why she notices you? It's a violent colour. It's horrible. Don't do that.
Do what?
Don't give me that look.
Kathy, you're being quite strange.
You make me feel so proud. I see people watching you walk down the street and I think he's my boyfriend. And now you do this to me.
Do what to you?
I was talking to my mum. Oh. She told me she saw you.
Oh, which she must have enjoyed.
On Monday morning.
Whereabouts?
Good mind games. Good idea, John, play your little funny magic tricks.
What magic tricks? What are you talking about, magic tricks? I was in work on Monday morning.
She saw what you did.
You're talking entirely in riddles, you lunatic.
With my best friend. Fucking her. She did, John, so don't try and deny it, because if you try and deny it, I'll pick something really heavy up and smash it into the back of your head.
I didn't do anything, she's lying.
I just told you not to deny it. I don't believe you just denied it when I told you really clearly not to.
It's what mothers do, Kathy. Believe me, I fucking know, mate.
Be quiet.
Oh, I'm getting a little bit on there. They have to confess.
You fucking coward. I called Mr. Kirkby. He told me he'd not been in work in 2 weeks.
You called him?
I can't believe I didn't notice.
You spoke to Mr. Kirkby behind my back. Do you remember what your life was like before you met me? Living in your pissy little house with your pissy little mother. Waddling around Reddish Road with your pissy little friend. Waiting for buses, admiring the beauty of Reddish Vale. Now I gave you a universe of opportunity. Don't think I didn't because I did. It was one fuck, it didn't mean anything. I swear to Christ, Kathy, if you lay one more finger on me ever again, I will fucking brain you, so God help me, I will.
It's nothing compared to what I'm going to do.
Oh, what do you mean, Emmy?
Have a guess. No, you'll never be able to.
Are you crying? I've never seen you cry before. You don't cry. Oh, don't, Kathy. Don't cry. Oh, I feel awful now.
Oh, fuck off.
Here.
Don't.
Real tears.
Please, John, don't.
Oh, your mother, what's she like? We'll go and talk to the crazy old cunt, both of us. I'll hold your hand.
John, don't. 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 Don't.
Sit back and make you smile.
Well, at least now I can say that I've eaten
Nigerian food.
A ball of fire. That shit doesn't need to be hot.
Must be true what they say. Why people can't handle pepper.
Must be. You know, my actual belly button's hurting.
Well, I hope this bad experience doesn't put you off Nigerian food for good.
Not a bad one. Just a hot one.
The whole eating with your hands thing.
Yeah, I hope that wasn't too strange for you.
I take some getting used to.
It doesn't come natural to you, does it?
Now I'm used to using cutlery, aren't I?
Of course.
Kinda made us feel. Kinda felt a bit like an animal.
Like an animal? Wow.
Yeah. Do you know what I mean?
No! No! This is my culture, so no!
Well, I don't understand why you can't just use cutlery as all.
Have you ever smelt your hand after?
Whoa, stop! Slow down there, cowboy. You're not gonna say something nasty, are you?
No!
No! Just checking. Okay, we saved you a spade.
Have
I ever smelt my hand after dot dot dot?
Have you ever smelt?
Do you know how odd the beginning of that question sounds? Really odd, but go on.
Yeah,
have a go.
Have you ever smelt your hand after you've held the scaffolding pole?
Is that a real question?
So.
Well, yes. I have smelt my hands after I've held the scaffolding pole. It smells dodgy after I've held the scaffolding pole, but where's this train heading, sorry?
Smells dodgy.
From my experience, yes. Not that I go around gripping scaffolding poles for a living or nothing, but what's your point, mister?
Using cutlery adds a dodgy taste of food, is my point.
Cutlery gives it a funny taste.
Yeah.
We ought to try stainless steel then, babe. Pan shop.
Lick a stainless steel spoon and try tell me there's no taste.
I beg your pardon?
Lick. Stainless steel spoon, and try tell me there's no taste. What?
Well, I don't have many people ordering us to lick things, is all.
Well, you're only young. Do you cook?
Must be joking. Couldn't cook to save me life.
What do you eat every day?
Dunno.
You don't know?
What do I eat? Fish and chips. Whatever's around, I guess.
You eat that with cutlery, then? Knife and fork?
No.
But I thought you said you don't eat with your hands.
It's fish and chips.
Right!
Oh, come on.
You don't feel like an animal when you're eating that, do you? It's just the African food.
No, I'm not saying that at all.
You know, girls that can't cook always confuses me.
Well, I live with my old man, you see. Can't exactly learn off him.
Someday you'll need to learn how to cook.
Well, I will one day, but for now, you know, I'm just 16 years old, so pretty much enjoy your being that, really. Which means sometimes dinner's 5 or 10 custard creams.
There is. But let me tell you, if you're with a black man, you need to know how to cook and properly.
You always this intense.
Black men like to eat.
Only black men.
How many pairs of jeans should I take? Oh, what about Wolf the dog? Will I look stupid with him on my bed? Oh, my posters are embarrassing. I need some art prints in proper frames, but not like Picasso or Matisse, because that's such a cliche. But what other artists are there? Have you started packing yet?
No.
Oh, look at my room, it's a bonsai! Have you read everything on your reading list? Because I'm stuck on the first one.
No,
I just keep reading the same page over and over again, because I have to look up every other word, and I just can't be bothered.
Lorna!
What?
I went to the doctor.
What?
He says I'm 3 months pregnant.
No.
Yes.
But
I'm sorry.
I don't understand.
Mike?
What? Mike? No!
Don't be angry.
Grace, you're leaving next week. We're leaving next week.
I can't.
You have to.
I don't know what to do. Tell me what to do. Look at me.
You can get a pill. 2 pills. You just get them from the doctor. I think it'll come out in the toilet or something. It's easy.
It's too late for that.
Well, then just get it taken out.
It's too late for anything. I just have to have it. I've been riding my bike everywhere.
What?
I thought it might do something.
Why would you do that? That's stupid,
Grace. I'm cleverer than you.
So I'm supposed to just go on my own?
I don't know.
Oh, was it really worth it? For just one last time with him?
It wasn't just once.
What?
We did it loads and loads of times after that, and I didn't tell you. Lorna, look at me.
There's something wrong with you.
There isn't.
Even at my own father's funeral, even then.
There's nothing wrong with
me.
I
saw you. His hand in your knickers. You couldn't even look at me. You couldn't even tell me you were sorry.
I didn't know what to say.
It's like you're obsessed. It's not normal.
It wasn't about that. I was just...
Now look what's happened to you. You have just escaped one prison, and now you are locking yourself in another one. Why would you do that?
I hate the way you talk about my life, like I'm supposed to be ashamed. At least I'm not trying to be a little girl for the rest of my life.
What? I listened to you earlier, chattering away like you're 11 years old.
Why are you so frightened by your body, Lorna? Why does it disturb you so much? Why are you so afraid to let yourself go? Because you're scared of what you'll find. Because you're scared you're like your mother.
Oh, shut up!
Look at yourself in the mirror. Look at yourself and accept what you are. That's why all the boys want you, because they can smell it.
Get out of my room!
Why do you think Christopher lavishes you all that attention, Why do you think all those men beat their horns and chase you down the street and try to put their hands up your skirt? You know it, and I know it.
It doesn't mean you're better, it just means that deep down, you're filled! Get out! Now! This is the best thing that's ever happened to you. This way you get to sail off and be special, and I get to stay here and be nothing. Because that's what I deserve, isn't it? Because I am nothing. Isn't that what you think?
Of course it isn't. You are worth so much more than me. Everybody knows it.
Touch me again and I'll kill you!
I am looking for love. I am actively looking for love. You know those traffic light parties where you wear red if you're not available, amber if you might be, and green if you absolutely are? Well, I'm on green, constantly. Sometimes I feel like my heart's gonna fall out of my ribcage the pace at which it beats. I like a lot of things. I love a lot of things. I like Facebook, which I sort of hate because I like to think of myself as a sort of artsy person, a bit of a free spirit even. I would say I was a feminist. Probably not in front of a boyfriend though. Not very sexy, is it? I've been told I smile a lot. I was once told my smile was my best feature. My bum's my worst, I know. I've never done online dating. I did once put an ad out. I had to come up with a little tagline. So I had, insert something witty here. And I just got a lot of dick pics, so I had to start again. Small smiler seeks man with hands that might be good at holding my hand. Tolerance of kind of feminist since 80s pop, potatoes and leg warmers essential, knowledge of stars, clincher. I've mapped the heavens through the constellations in those little glow-in-the-dark stars on every bedroom ceiling I've had since I was 8. Still searching.
What the fuck are you doing, Stace?
You what?
You doing?
No,
where have you been?
What?
I've been looking all over for you.
Well, you can't look that far, because we've stood here for a fucking half an hour.
Isn't that right?
Why, what?
And I'm doing all the fucking work, then, or what?
You what?
I've been in and out of Smith's twice, through Pret and Paper Chase, 5 fucking times. I'm not seeing you anywhere near me, so I don't know what the fuck's happening.
Yeah, well, I've not seen you either, have I?
Obviously not, if you've been stood there all the fucking time.
I've been through Paper Chase and all, you know, Jade.
Have you?
Yes.
What, in disguise?
No.
Well, how come I missed you then? I mean, I'm running around like somebody not right, and I'm thinking, where is she? I've got nobody to palm stuff to. You're fucking hanging around McDonald's like we're on a fucking day trip.
Joe's gone.
What?
They've got him.
Eh?
Said they fucking got Joe. What do you want me to do? Shout it across the station, you dozy cunt.
Have they?
About 10 minutes ago.
What?
Right fucking commotion.
Please.
No, aliens.
How many?
What, aliens?
Funny.
6.
Oh, fucking great. I heard shout him, but...
He must have got stuck because they followed him on down there.
Well, where's Wayne then?
Blended.
Did they take Joe off then?
No, they went for a fucking cocktail in the Alchemist.
Does he have the gear then?
Yeah, he was buzzing his tits off.
Fucking great.
Like whatever he just took, he'd just take
it. Oh, great. So what do you do then?
Dunno.
Did you nick out?
Got a couple of bits from Funky Pigeon.
What?
Got a couple of bits from Funky Pigeon.
Where the fuck is that?
Over by the bugs.
What? That little place that all the tossers go in?
It's alright, actually. It's got some cool stuff.
Like what?
Some of stuff.
What did you get then?
Got a Get Well Soon card.
What?
Can we go?
Oh, right.
Nice enough.
Fucking hell. Joe's been nicked. You've got a fucking Get Well Soon card.
And a rubber.
A what?
A rubber.
Why?
I needed one.
You need a rubber?
Yeah.
Fucking hell.
It's cute. Got you one and all.
What? Why?
Just this.
Fucking hell, Stacey. You losing it?
I'm thinking of giving this a bit of a miss, to be fair.
You what?
All this hanging about the station on weekends, waiting for Joe to pick which one of us he wants to go first.
And do what?
I'm gonna go up Leeds City College, do that hairdressing course that Ellie's doing.
Ellie's a twat. Hairdressing's for twats.
I know.
I want to be a fucking hairdresser for the rest of your life. Fuck me.
Why, what are you gonna do?
I don't know. Not go to tech. I'll be a fucking hairdresser. I can't think of a worse. I'd rather do this. At least it's exciting.
It's
it is.
Well. It's shit, Jade. It's pointless. What are we, just bits and now waiting for Joe and Wayne to click the fingers and then what? I'm better than that, mate.
Oh, are you?
Yes.
Are you good?
Yes. And you are and all.
I'm a girl. Because I don't think I am, to be fair. I think this is all I'm good for, because I'm fucking useless, really. You know that I am. I'm just fucking useless, aren't I? Going then?
Yeah.
Fucking great.
Here, I nearly forgot.
What?
Is that woodwork got you?
What am I supposed to do with that?
Rub some out, start again.
Fucking funny.
You know you're going to have to give me one tonight.
Oh, babe, let me have some peace, will you?
I'm only saying. We didn't do it last night. I know you're upset about your Uncle Len, but you just got to get on with it. And if we don't do it tonight, it's going to be another month then a shit out.
Oh, fucking hell.
Don't fucking help me, Barry. I love you, 19.
You haven't said anything to Mum, have you?
No, Barry. That's your job.
Oh, she's going to go fucking spare.
Well, when we move in here and when we've got family, we can't have her here. I mean, if we have IVF, we could have twins. We could have triplets.
Oh, don't give me nightmares.
That's a nice thing to say.
Don't twist
that's
it.
That's what you think, is no. it? You think having a baby's a nightmare?
Jackie, darling. Chill, chill, take a chill pill.
Don't you think I'm horny anymore? I can stick a finger up your bum. Apparently it's really good.
Jackie!
Hang on now.
Jackie, they're upstairs.
It'll be ages. Oh, I'd love to do it while there's a bicker in
Jackie,
here.
Jackie, turn it in.
He's right, dirty.
Jackie!
God, let me right,
Jackie! Jackie, I know you've got the yawn, but there's a time and a place.
Haven't you heard that sex and death are symbiotic to each other?
Fucking what?
That's a thick as shit, Barry, you really are.
You're not fun anymore, Barry. There's a lot of men would love it on a plate like you get it. I'll never turn you down, even when I'm on the blob. I'm always up for it, and at one time so are you. I don't know what's happened to you, Barry. And don't think I don't get offers. Men always fancy me. I could go out and get sex like that.
Well, fucking go and get it then and see what happens.
I didn't mean it, Barry.
Oh, I know you didn't.
I'm stressed.
I know you're stressed, but this. It doesn't help you, does it?
You don't tell me you love me no more, Barry.
So who knows?
Who?
Lee, come on, it's me.
Okay.
Is this really happening? Are you not going to tell me about your night? I've got you. It's not too late to fix this. I'm sure you've told Jimmy, but hasn't gotten back to Davis yet.
Thank you for your concern, Grace, but you're making me a little uncomfortable with the... I just don't think it's any of your business right now.
Lee, baby, the words you're using, there are incredible ramifications for this. I know you know that.
I do know that.
So let's do what's right here, okay? Well, you can't expect me to stand with you on this.
Okay, got it.
Don't do that to me.
I'm not really worried about you right now.
You're playing with fire.
Is that what I'm doing?
You're making a mess. Just tell me what you're saying and we can come up with a plan.
I couldn't walk.
When?
We got home and I couldn't walk.
You were drunk.
Okay.
Well, Lee, how am I supposed to react? Huh? Your sister is in the apartment blabbing on about rape, so tell me what is going on.
You tell me. It seems like you have a pretty good idea.
I have an inkling, yes.
You think I made it up?
You're pretending that you didn't?
There's not even a moment of doubt, huh? You're that sure?
I was there, Lee.
Not the whole time.
I was listening.
Not the whole time!
This is so fucked!
So what do you want from me, Grace?
I just want you to spread them wider next time. Maybe that way the whole team can fit in.
No. No, you want me to confide in you. And cry in your arms. Oh, and then maybe I'll realize the person I love has been right here all along like you've dreamt. And you'll think, I'm so glad I took care of her and paid her rent. It finally paid off. You want me to tell you it was a lie so you can help me out of it. You want me to open my legs wider so you can fit in.
Well, now we know where we stand. You know, if you are telling the truth about all of this, I hope it hurt.
How do you know you can trust me?
I don't know. There's just something about you. I don't know what it is.
Oh, really? You know, I'll tell you what there is about me. There is this overwhelming, this all-pervading hatred. A hatred for people like you, for people who lay even the littlest of finger on children. I wake up with it. It wakes me up. It rises me on the bus to work. It whispers to me. They will not get away with it.
I come in. I make sure all the bindings are clean and the electrodes are in the right order so we won't waste time. I admit it. Sometimes I use excessive force, and sometimes I use excessive force on an entirely innocent individual. But I'll tell you this, if an entirely innocent individual leaves this room for the outside world,
They're not even going to contemplate raising their voice to a little kid again, just in case I hear them and drag them back in here for another load of excessive fucking force. Now, is this kind of behaviour in an officer of the law in some way questionable morally? Of course it fucking is! But you know what? I don't care.
Hi! Look at you! What's going on?
Nothing.
Wow, turn around. You look great.
No, I look like a dead deer bloated on the highway.
No, you look like a pretty deer who's still alive.
Oh. Bitch.
Your hair's long.
Yeah.
So mermaid-y.
Oh, I got this whole intricate sewn-in system under there, but it's human.
Okay, well, we gotta be careful when we buy fake hair because some countries give their young girls chicken hormones and make them grow it in their basements.
Do they get paid? Because I would do that. So, what's your deal? You been doing anything fun?
Yeah. Rescue dogs have so many hidden skills. I've been teaching Polenta how to smell diabetes.
You've been single for 2 years. You should at least be going to TGI Fridays with your work friends or some basic shit, instead of spending the night on Skype dates with mom and dad.
I've been having a lot of fun. I've been teaching myself how to make cheese.
Oh?
I'm fine. I'm good. I'm real good. What about you? Do you have a plan or a place to live?
I have an idea that's gonna solve everything. Haley's gonna flip.
What's your idea?
I think we should come down here and move in with mom and dad for a while.
So I've been thinking.
Why?
You asserted yourself and you got a job. So maybe I could get you a loan to get a new place.
When you say loan, do you mean the kind you pay back or like a wink wink loan?
All loans are supposed to be paid back.
Not in my experience.
You can do that now because you have a job.
I do. Woo! That's an awesome offer. All right.
Okay, wait. I'm going to ask for something in return for the money. And I don't want you to think that this loan is contingent on that, but I will say that if you don't do what I ask, I feel like I might not give you the money.
Okay, great. What?
Oh, this is a lot harder than I thought. Just give me a minute. Will you be the party mom tonight so I can let my freak flag fly?
I would love to.
Yeah? Because your face is telling me something else.
That would bring me joy.
You know what? Forget it. It'll get screwed up all day.
You don't think I can take care of people? I'm an actual mom. I got this.
Okay, but the party mom can't drink.
What fresh fuckery is that?
Does it want to drink at a kid's birthday party?
Yeah, if there's a lifeguard.
No! I don't mind. It's fine. It's okay.
Okay, I won't drink tonight. You groin it up. I'll be you, you be me.
Oh my god, so many red flags! Okay, let's do this.
Bro!
Hey.
Did your chin catch Dutch fur disease?
Oh, fuck you.
I do!
Days.
Oh, well done. That's great. Well, you picked a terrible place to come and see me because it reeks of hops all the way down the street outside here. Did you notice that?
No.
Rob, I hope you're not here to talk.
It's about that, yeah. I've been thinking about it again that night.
Rob?
I can't not think about it.
You said we'd put it out of our minds. Weren't we just going to try and keep it out?
I can't. I'm sorry.
It was a long time ago.
Well, in here, it's now.
Yeah. I know. Well, why today? Why is it preying on your mind today?
There's a news article.
A news article?
Oh, featured article, whatever the hell you call it. Look, that's his wife.
You don't know that's his wife?
There's a photo of him at the bottom, look. That's him. And the poor cunt, they never found him, so she never remarried. She never fucking moved house. She stayed where she is in case he came back. Fucking all this time, Mia, she's still waiting for him.
That's dreadful, but what can we do?
I'm gonna write her a letter.
No.
Anonymous, I'm not gonna mention you.
Rob, No, you'll bring up God knows what. You'll just rake it all up again.
Well, I can't live with this, Mia.
Because there are things they can do, because they can trace it. They can trace it back. They'll find the body, and then they'll find us.
No, they won't find us.
Yes, they will, and then we're fucked.
Look, when I quit alcohol, they told me to make amends with anyone I've ever hurt. Now, who have I hurt more than her?
What about me?
What about her?
No, 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 no. Fuck! This was your idea. This was your fucking idea.
I know. I know, and I'm sorry.
5 years. 5 years! Fucking shame. The fucking guilt. I've got somewhere. I've done something with my life. You haven't. You
well,
don't
that's not the point, though.
You don't understand. I have a son. He's 2 years old. You've seen pictures of him. Think of him, please.
I'm sorry.
I sat on this for you. I fucking sat on this for you.
I'm sorry.
I've made up my mind. That's how it is.
Rob, listen, listen. I understand.
Do you?
Yes. Come on, let's talk
about it. I'm God. Mia! Fucking leaving! Let me the fuck go! Oh. Alright.
You scared me.
I've seen you before.
Oh yeah? Where?
Here.
At the hospital.
No. Exactly here. You always come to the top of this building. You leave out the fire exit. You make sure no one's watching, and you always stand about 2 feet away from the edge.
You're observant.
First few times you just came up here to think, I think. But the last time you've come up here, you looked at that letter.
And intrusive.
What is it?
A letter. It's a letter from a uni.
Oh, which one?
Who are you?
Oh, shit. Sorry. Yeah, I'm Eli. Actually, Elijah. Like that dude who plays Frodo in Lord of the Rings.
I've seen
him. Yeah, me neither. Anyway, my mum, she was one of those people who gives a kid a full name, but only uses a nickname, which is weird, because most people, they kick off when other people give their kid a nickname. Like, that's not their name. Anyway, Eli.
Sasha, why are you following me? And don't say you're not, because you basically admitted it.
I saw you arguing with your dad.
He's not my dad.
Well, whoever he is, he upset you and you came up here.
And you followed me.
Well, yeah, I guess. I guess I was worried about you. You look like someone I know. You look sad. Plus, when I came up here, you basically walked towards the edge, and I thought, you know, but I best stay here and
get it. I want to jump!
Well, I know that now, don't I? So, who's the letter from?
Oxford Uni.
Bloody hell, I thought you'd be the type to get into Oxford.
What the fuck's that supposed to mean? Because I have a posh accent or wear posh clothes, I'm automatically not smart enough to get into Oxford.
No,
is that what you're saying?
No. Yes, I mean, I guess that was my assumption, but, you know, clearly wrong. Fuck me, Oxford, that's amazing!
Yeah, I can't go!
Why not?
Because my nan, she's dying, and if I go next week, I won't be here to say goodbye, and I'd never forgive myself.
I think you would. You'd forgive yourself. Your nan's dying, and I get that's horrible, but you can't give up your whole future.
For what? Someone who doesn't have a future?
That's not what I'm saying.
What are you saying then? Stop pretending you know anything about the situation I'm in. You don't know anything about me, and I don't know anything about you. Except for the fact that you follow me to the roof sometimes, which
my
is weird.
My sister.
What about her?
She's got leukemia. She's 9. She's been in and out of hospital for the last 2 years, and recently she's been in for 4 weeks. She's gonna die, we know that.
Sorry.
You're right. I don't know what you're going through. I've had your whole life with your nan, and she's had her whole life. My sister, she's 9. She'll never be 10. Look, I know it's hard to feel what is like light years away when you want to be right here, but Oxford, man, that's big.
Yeah.
Your nan will want you to go for sure.
She does.
So, how are you getting there? Your dad going to drop you?
Dad, I'll probably get the train.
What about all your stuff?
Don't have much.
I'll give you a lift if you want.
You don't just give a lift to Oxford, it's not exactly down the road.
I'm going that way anyway. I go to Oxford. Brooks, it's not quite.
You don't even know me.
But I'd like to, Sasha.
I want us to finish.
Oh, again?
Really this time?
We didn't mean it last time.
Please go back.
Why?
Just go right now. Just leave my house right now. Please.
No, not without an explanation.
I'm a prostitute.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
When you leave here, I'm going to go upstairs. I'll put my basque on, drive to Bolton, put the radio on top blast, and I'll screw strange men for money. It's better you hear it from me than from someone else.
Hey, you missed you.
So, that day off?
Yep.
Still wearing what you woke up in?
Mm-hmm.
I bothered to throw any of your empty cans in the bin, could have made some tea, but no. Okay, fine, I'm on it.
You've been in house less than a minute.
Yeah, and I wish that it were less than a second. You've been in all day. Lazy shit.
Don't start.
Oh, I bloody will start, you pissed me off.
You stood away at TV?
Yeah, I'll stand here all night.
Oh, really mature. I wish you didn't come on now, your attitude stinks.
Your lifestyle stinks, you slob.
I've worked all week. This is my meat.
Woo! What do you want for tea? Caviar, steak, and a blowjob.
Fuck me. At your service, give me a jacket, I'll go hang it up for you. Fancy a massage, I'll go get the baby oil. Get you a Deliveroo. Anything you want, you bratty little bitch.
You know what I want, Pa?
What?
A boyfriend with a brain. A boyfriend with a book to think it's Sunday. She's going to be tired. She juggles college. And a shitty job that treats the last
Let's get the little violin out then, shall we?
Yeah, please do so I can wrap it round your neck, funny lad.
Back down or back out?
I ain't going anywhere, pal. I pay far more than you do for this place and I can't even work full time. Trying to earn it. And live with a raccoon of a boyfriend like you.
Get yourself off then.
Take a leaf out your mate, guys. Fuck. He thinks. He thinks about his girlfriend. Had a chat with him at barbecue last week, actually. Seems decent.
Go get yourself off with Guy then. Nasty bitch!
Might go out tonight. Got a new dress that needs wearing.
It's nothing ever good enough for you, you whiny slag! I don't know what you want!
I'm miserable. I come home and I want to go straight back out. You might as well ram your dick in this drive. Where's the thought anymore? To help me out, I'll help you out. I am 19 and I feel crippled. Suffocated. You're constantly on my head with your negativity and I can't do this anymore. I can't bear you. I want to go places.
I
want to
stay here.
I want to see stuff.
I
want to
see me mates.
I want to feel part of your family.
I want to get away from my family.
I want kids.
I still want to be a kid. I want you to chill.
I want to leave.
I don't want what you want.
Then I don't want you.
You got the thumbs up from one of your punters. Do you know how we describe you? Tasty. Oh, me, everyone, very tasty, he says. How do you go from working in a DIY store to this? Show me your hands. Show me your hands.
I'm not on crack either. It's much worse than that. It's called having two kids and a mortgage. Flogging bed implants won't cover it.
Oh, but shagging suits will. How many are nice?
Doesn't matter.
How many?
9. Sometimes 10.
What was that, eh? Just a hobby.
Of course you weren't a hobby.
Damn. How long?
A year.
A year? How many is that, eh? 1,000? 1,000 men off? You're not sure to keep in a cardboard box, mate.
Really? Says the man who has his toes cut into soldiers by his mummy.
You know what I think about it, right? You made me beg. You had me dancing for peanuts like a monkey.
It wasn't like that, Mike. I swear to God, it wasn't like that.
How long did you think you could carry on lying? You know, I thought we had a future. Imagine it, eh? Shagged up with a prosy. A prosy tucking the kid up at night, reading her a bedtime story. I should have smelled it on you.
You don't know what it's like when you drop your kids up and they get frisked at registration. Oh, well, don't you dismiss my kids. Don't you dare dismiss my kids. Don't you dare do that.
Do you think this is what the boys would want?
Well, they're never going to find out, are they?
Well, I found
out. Oh, because I told you. I told you.
You look like a freak.
In 6 months, I'm going to be out of here and I'm going to have my kids in a good school. I've just got to do it in 6 more months.
You'll find a nice calf at your life or something and you'll shag a suit. And buy a new gear for the lads and you'll shag a suit. The car will break down. You'll shag a suit. Who's going to look twice at you now, eh? You're just the brass.
needed some air. Seeing all these old people is really tiring. I get like that sometimes, like art galleries, all the old paintings. Tiring.
What's going on?
Oh. My dad had a heart attack.
Oh.
Uh-huh.
Don't cry.
Don't cry.
I've kind of been going through some tough home shit as well.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's just, I've had this horse, Hullet. I've had him since I was like 12, and I think we're going to have to get him put down, like soon, and...
A horse?
Yeah.
That's not the same.
What?
A horse and a dad, that's not the same.
Well, I wasn't saying your dad was my horse, I was just saying...
Seriously not cool, Oregon. It's a horse. It's basically just a big fucking dog.
I know it's just basically, factually, just a horse, but it's like, Hullet was my whole childhood. It's about to be shot in the head.
Yeah, well, I guess that's pretty shit.
Thanks.
Hey. I kind of love the fact you've got a horse, though. You're one of me.
What? No, I'm not. Not really. Like,
no?
We had him on loan for the first few years, and then we bought him really cheap. And his tacks are always second hand, and like, I don't even wear proper boots, yeah? Like, I just wear trainers and fuck up my feet.
Ooh, edgy. Bronze horse!
Gotcha. You big Porsche?
What do you want?
Look, you don't know me.
I know that.
I was given your number.
By who?
Well, she told me not to say.
She...
No, I can't, I promise.
Whatever. I've never seen you before, so get lost. I'm away at the shops.
Look, please, I think you could be the only person who can help
Listen,
me.
Listen, pal, I don't want to help you. I've got stuff to do, homework and that.
Homework?
Aye.
How old are you?
17.
17?
Aye. I look old for my age. I can get to clubs, I can buy
No,
pads.
Sorry, I don't understand.
What don't you understand?
Well, I was given your number by a doctor.
Why?
I thought you'd be a nurse, pharmacist, someone with qualifications. Who are you?
You've got a knife.
What? No, of course not.
Open your top.
Excuse me?
I don't want to see your tits, pal. I want to see if you're recording.
I'm not.
I'm not taking any chances. I did 6 months in the Young Offenders and I'm no going back.
Look, I'm not recording anything. No one even knows I'm here. Okay, fine. See? Nothing. Now, can I please do this back up? Look, I've never done this before. I don't know what you might want to know. What's your name?
Jessica Rabbit. That's a lie, actually. My name's Sean Connery! I'm weird for a girl, but my dad's a big Bond fan.
Look, I'll be honest. I want you to trust me. I'll tell you anything you need to know.
What's your PIN code?
Why did your doctor give me your number?
I can get things.
Things?
Anything you can imagine. Anything at all.
Like what?
Name it.
Last remaining antibiotic?
Easy.
Truly.
If someone out there wants to sell it, I can get it.
How?
What? Do you mean how does a 17-year-old convicted criminal who lives in the arse end of Govan Hill get a hold of Grade A gear?
Yeah.
Well, that would be telling, wouldn't it?
No, sorry, I'm utterly confused.
Ah, you look
Would you please tell me what you're talking about?
The dark web.
The dark web.
Don't say it like that. You make it sound pure boring.
Computers.
I'm the best at computers. I can hack anything. Any system, any code. The dark web is my Lidl.
What?
I'm gonna do my shopping.
I'm only interested in the antibiotics.
Nah, I can't help you.
But you just said!
This before.
How's that?
Before I got caught. I've still got my tag. I'm not permitted to. A smartphone, personal laptop, computer. I've learned my lesson. I'm studying for my exams. 10 minutes online, I could buy the exam papers, but I'm choosing to do them legit. Show the bastards.
How much would the antibiotics cost? We have money. Name your price.
I don't want your money.
How much? 1,000.
Did you hear what I just said? I'm done with all that.
5,000. 10,000. Would 10,000 be enough?
I'm not putting my whole life on the line so you can clear up your middle class ear infection.
It's not for me.
Well, who cares?
Please, wait.
Get off me.
Please, I'm desperate.
Why should I?
For my daughter, Sarah. She's sick. Please.
We dance until the sun comes up. And I know he wants to take me home, and I say, okay.
Because at last I'm living and I don't want life to stop.
And when he kisses me, I want to cry because I've never been kissed like that before. I've never been kissed where
he kissed me. On the third night, I watch him sleeping and I do that thing you shouldn't do. I think about the future and taking him home, and then he wakes up and looks at me as if he wants to get up and run, and so I kiss him on his lips before he can. I think, is this it? Is this what falling in love is? And when I wake up in the morning, he's gone. Along with 400 euros, my iPad, and a large piece of my heart. I walk through the streets of Berlin. I feel small. I want my dad. I want my mum, but I can't think about them too much because if I do, my chest will explode. I feel like I'm literally going to fall to pieces. And so, to stop myself, I make a list of all the things I know to be true. And the real frightening thing is that it's a very short list.
I could find the whole meaning of life in those sad eyes. They sing things you never quite say, but I hear.
You come out of hiding, I'm right here beside you. And I'll stay there as long as you'll let me.
'Cause you matter to me, simple and plain, and not much to ask from somebody. You matter to me.
Roland, I'm really sorry.
What is it?
James and I had sex.
James?
From work.
Dandruff? You mean the bloke with the dandruff?
Yes.
When?
Well, there's been a few times.
How many's a few?
Well, I'd rather we didn't get into who did what to whom.
How many's a few, Mary?
Six? Maybe seven?
Spread out? Were the six or seven times you had sex spread out over a particular period of time?
Yes.
Not together then? Do you want to be together? Mary, did the two of you want
to
be?
I don't know!
Is he moving in? Wait, do you want me to move out?
There's no rush.
Wait, did you have sex?
all sorts of places.
Fuck does that mean?
Well, it means we've had sex in more than one place.
Sex in the daytime?
Yes.
Fucking daytime.
Sometimes, yes.
So when's he moving in, Mary?
There's no date.
He's moving in.
Hopefully.
Am I boring?
What?
Do I bore you?
Of course not.
We don't talk enough about space, is that it?
It's nothing to do with work.
Does it make it better? If you'd said, yes, it's to do with space, it might make a bit more sense. I'd kick myself for not making more of an effort, but at least it would make a bit more sense.
Linear explanation, I'm afraid.
Don't make me leave.
Roland.
This is the best fucking thing that has ever happened to me. I'm serious.
You'll be fine.
What am I gonna do?
Well, you could move back to Tower Hamlets.
Is that meant to be a joke?
Of course it's not. I just meant that there's lots that you could do.
How long have you been waiting to tell me?
A week. Sorry, I'm going on about myself.
Oh, no, 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 it's fine. It's good to listen to a human voice. It's been a while. Helps me calm down.
John.
Thanks for coming.
John, what's the matter?
I don't really know where to start. I'm so sorry about all this.
Just tell me, it's okay.
I shouldn't have called you.
I'm family. You're meant to call me.
Well, I suspect you're not going to think of me as family after this. In fact, technically, I'm not sure I count as family any longer.
Are you having an affair?
No, I'm not having an affair. I've never had an affair. Never thought about having an affair.
Is Kay having an affair?
No, Kay's not having an affair. Or rather, she wasn't. I'm fairly sure she wasn't. It's hard to be certain about that kind of thing, really.
Has something happened in Oslo?
Kay's not in Oslo.
No? Where is she?
She's in the cellar.
And what's she doing in the cellar?
She's dead.
You said she was in the cellar?
She's dead and she's in the
cellar. What are you talking about?
Ironically, she didn't kill herself, if that's what you're thinking.
Well, John, don't fuck around like this.
You see, actually, I killed her.
You're serious?
We had a fight. I pushed her and she fell. There was such a small amount of blood. You expect there to be a lot of blood, don't you, from the films? But
Jesus,
there really
Christ
wasn't.
Christ.
No, sorry, John. She's in a bit of a mess. You go stiff after a bit and I had to kind of fold her to get her down the stairs. She doesn't smell too good either.
What the fuck have you done? You killed my sister! Why didn't you call an ambulance? Answer the fucking question!
Sorry, but she was dead.
I asked you why you didn't call an ambulance.
Her heart had stopped. 3 minutes without oxygen and the brain starts to die. We're a long way from the nearest hospital, Sandy.
And what if there was one passing? What if there was one nearby? What if there was a million to one chance that she could have...
To tell you the truth, I didn't want someone to come and take her away.
So you put her in the cellar?
Well, I didn't want to be on my own.
This can't be true. It can't be. I'm ringing the police.
Well, this was a few days ago, incidentally, which accounts for my dishevelled state and the smell down there.
Well, how many days ago?
4, maybe 5. I've lost track of time, rather. That's why I put her in the bag. It's what the whole carpet was delivered in. Don't ring the police.
You're asking me to pretend this didn't happen?
We can sort it
out. No, we can't sort it out. This is not something you sort out. Tell me where the phone is. Tell me where the fucking phone is, or I swear to God.
It's there. I thought maybe you could help me bury her.
You cut the cord.
With the kitchen scissors.
John?
I really need you to help me, Sandy.
John, I'm leaving.
You can't leave, Sandy.
Yeah? And how are you going to stop me?
Strange what people spend their time on. We're staring at this shite. You know, I can take a shining screen out of soft fucking hands and the pricks will keep staring. It'll be for a crowd before they look up. I leave them looking confused, realising how grey it all is about their little screens. That's what really scares them, not me. They look up and work out their loss. They sometimes cry. Imagine how much dog shit gets stepped in each day for that staring. How many lampposts hit? How many skulls split by buses, bones broke, skins ripped along roads for not looking up at crossings? I fly past these blind bastards. I can go anywhere. Under those stairs and into pockets, along trains and through houses, round coppers, over shit, over the city. I can get through an entire town without a single eye touching me. Be the problem.
Can't be having that for too long. Get lonely. Shut out. Better start finding ways back into those stairs. So now and again, I don't disappear into the crowd. They scream and shout at me and I stand there watching. I like to see them run out of breath, look around, work it out. Streak's still moving, dickhead. No one's watching, no one cares. And when I know, they know, anything's possible. I walk right up to them, a smile, and walk away.
I'm so sorry I'm late.
Oh, it's okay.
And I can't stay very long. Oh God, I'm already late for my next-
Would you like to make-
No. God, no.
Okay,
Ooh, this is pretty. This one, oh wow.
Yeah? That's just the primed canvas. That is-
Oh, well, sold.
These are all new.
Okay, I'm ready.
This is so-
Yeah.
Disturbing.
Oh, well, I don't know what Judy told you about the word.
Did someone like lock you in the trunk of a car on acid when you were five or something?
Not exactly.
I'm sorry, but I want something to hang in my home, where I live. I don't understand why people make art that upsets other people. I'm sorry.
I don't think you should buy it then.
Do you have anything serene, or joyful?
I don't really...
Something that would make me want to suppress the suicidal impulse? I think you bring people up here to frighten them.
I don't do that!
How much are these?
That is $5,000.
Do you have... Look, do you have anything more in
there? In taupe? Or are you looking for something more in saffron?
Are you mocking me?
No! You want something to make you feel good about yourself?
Yes.
Nothing wrong with that.
I don't think there is.
No, but you don't want a painting.
You want an enema.
Okay.
You want a fluffer.
Nice.
A pharmaceutical lift. Complimentary shiatsu.
I am the customer.
You are what's in the painting. Each and every one. That is you staring out, staring back at you.
I could buy a mirror then.
No, that will lie. That's why it's so much cheaper. You pay me to tell the truth, the way you pay your whore to leave when you're done. You see what's real, what's actually there, the good and the bad. And if that's not what you want, then stop right next door, pick up a bottle of peppered vodka, and knock yourself out.
Mm-hmm. Can I ask you a question?
By all means.
How many of these have you sold?
None. That would be none of your business. Of your business.
Oh, you talk about the truth.
Oh, I've sold paintings.
Uh-huh.
But what I will not sell
Please,
is myself short.
Contorted grammar aside, what are you doing later?
And why?
Are you free this evening?
I am free this evening.
Would you like to have dinner with me?
I'll put on the list.
Done.
Right after removing my own teeth with shit-covered pliers, and sucking off all my father's golf buddies.
Well, you have beautiful teeth, so don't do that. And I'm much more satisfying than anyone's golf buddies.
I think I should be the judge of that.
Seven?
Jumping late.
I like you.
Do you want to go?
No, not right now.
I understand.
You understand what?
You. Ooh. I understand you. We'll go when you're ready.
Thank you.
Let's celebrate. I want to feed you.
I want some eggs benedict. About cafe?
Well, it's eggs royale, but anything for you, my darling.
Eggs royale? Should we just go like this?
Yeah, definitely.
How do I look?
Like a Rembrandt.
That's not a huge compliment, is it?
Well, he painted tender pictures of women he loved. Bruised, vulnerable women. Beautiful as fuck.
Oh, I'm fucking hungry. I'm pregnant.
Bad joke.
I am. Actually pregnant again.
Eggs royale for three, then.
I'm being serious.
Oh, so am I, Joanna. Smoking for three?
No.
Drinking for three?
Four tests.
I'm a mummy.
You're perverted.
No, I'm pregnant.
When did you find out?
Last week.
What about the pill?
I must have forgotten to take it.
I saw them in your bag. They're
I must have
in your bag. What the fuck is going on?
Calm down.
Did you come off the pill?
Do you want it?
Yes. Do you?
Yes.
Look at me.
serious. I'm so happy, Amina. Oh, I mean, when we, last time, every fiber of my being was screaming, this is wrong, and I knew, I could just feel that you knew it too. You came off the pill, you sneaky bitch. We are meant to do this, together, you and I. Why are there no words for this feeling? I'm happy. I love you, I'm happy. Are you happy? Okay, well, hold on, I mean, we need to talk about this seriously. I mean, are you willing to do this with me?
Yes.
Fuck, we were gonna be good. I love you.
I love you too.
What's in your head? What are you thinking?
I lied. I'm a liar. There's no...
No.
B. Gotcha.
You finally found the right words. You've done it. You're extraordinary. What are you doing?
What's it look like I'm doing?
Number twos?
No!
Number threes?
What's number threes?
Both.
Number ones. Get out then!
Why?
What do you mean, why? I can't pee with you standing there.
Why not?
Because I just can't. I can't do it with anybody in the room.
Try.
No!
No! You don't love me, do you?
Oh, what's that got to do with?
What's love got to do with it?
What's love for a second-hand emotion?
Do you not trust me?
Yes, sort of.
Sort of?
Look, it doesn't matter whether I trust you or not. I can't do the toilet with anybody in the room. I can't even do it with my sister in the room.
Well, there's lots of stuff you do with me that you wouldn't do with your sister. Well, outside of my masturbatory fantasies.
That's disgusting. Do you think about that?
What?
About me doing stuff with my sister?
Maybe.
What sort of things?
Well, just being tender and sisterly with each other. Sometimes using a double-ended dildo.
Disgusting! You dirty perv. Please, I really am desperate.
Well, you can't be that desperate. Two people that love each other, they should be able to pee in the same room.
See, that is where we differ. I don't think peeing has anything to do with us.
But I don't want you to piss on my face. Oh. I just want you to pee with me here in the room.
Why?
I don't know, because that's something you've never done with anyone else.
I don't think I can.
Try. Sometimes you need to kickstart the bike, I understand. But just think of cool, clear water flowing. A rushing brook, Niagara Falls. Waves crashing against the pier. Something's happening.
At the hotel.
Yeah, we
had a dream.
I remember.
You were laughing at the karaoke.
Yes, I was.
And then you went and did it.
And you didn't. I remember it well.
Sorry,
yeah.
I can't sing. That's all.
Did you hear me up there?
You were good. And that girl with you.
Libby.
She was great.
She was good. I was energetic.
Yeah, you were definitely energetic. Where is Libby?
Oh, she met someone, so.
Right.
One of the locals, actually. Slightly terrifying, but you.
Me?
What are you doing here?
I couldn't sleep, that's all, so I thought I'd watch the sun come up for a bit.
How very poetic of you.
No, I mean, I just sort of owe it to someone, so...
You owe it to someone?
It's a bit of a long story.
Okay. Well, it's past my bedtime, so...
Listen! Sorry. Before you go, can I just... I want to apologise. The other night, when I said I was here with my girlfriend, I'm not.
I'm with my mum.
You came on holiday with your mum?
Yeah, I know it's a bit, but I'd paid for the flights already and she needed a break, so...
So, when you told me you had to get back to your girlfriend...
Yeah, I was lying, yeah.
Then... what? Then keep lying, don't tell me now! That was fine, he's got a girlfriend, it's fine, you haven't just been completely rejected, it's because he's got a girlfriend back in his room, otherwise he'd have definitely said yes to a drink or an 80s duet or whatever! But you didn't!
No,
and you don't have a girlfriend, so you just didn't fancy him.
I did!
Which is fine, by the way. Why tell me now?
Honestly, I do fancy you. I think you're, yeah. Well, I was kicking myself, really. I was, just before even, when you got here just now. I was thinking about you, and the point is, I think you're lovely. And I'm sorry I pretended I had a girlfriend when I don't.
So why did you?
I've only got one ball.
What?
Yeah.
Like Hitler?
No.
I'm not saying you're like Hitler.
But that's why I didn't want to get to that bit and...
A bit presumptuous?
No, I mean, not just the other night, but ever, really.
I'm kidding.
Okay.
So it's pretty recent, then?
Well, yeah.
And you haven't since?
No,
you haven't.
So that's why.
Well, that's brilliant.
Is it?
It's not brilliant, but...
No.
When I was younger, I had a boyfriend who only had pubes on the left-hand side. Spilled boiling water down himself when he was a kid, then had a skin graft from somewhere, so he couldn't grow hair on the right. He was just... shiny. Yeah, I think that was probably weirder.
But you admit it's weird then, mine?
Well, probably, yeah. But no one cares about the balls, do they? They're just the backing singers. As long as the front man's doing his job.
I can't believe your orgasm song is playing! How great is this?
I'm pregnant, I should not be up to
her. Oh, come on, you're like a week pregnant. A couple of drinks and some MDMA are not going to hurt.
Where the hell are we?
I've never seen so many men in black mesh.
Would you stop it? I'm meeting a Tinder date here. Come on, let's get a drink.
No, I'm not drinking.
Come, please, I can't drink alone.
So I should harm my unborn child so you don't have to drink alone?
Yeah.
Do you think people will still find me hot after I give birth?
What? After your vagina's ripped in two and your stomach is sagging down to your knees?
Doubt it. Oh, my vagina. My beautiful vagina. You know, it's not like I'm not scared or anything. I have a life force growing inside of me, living off me, stealing my life, my youth.
Like a nit.
Exactly. You know breast milk? It's just blood without the red blood cells. I'm giving birth to a vampire.
An alien! You know, you could still not have it. No one will judge you. It's your decision. I mean, he probably doesn't even want it either.
Of course he does.
Well, I'm just saying most men don't want one until later because they can. Whereas this with you, it's tick-tock, tick-tock.
You know what? You're a horrible little bitch, and that's why no one likes you, and you're gonna die childless and alone.
Yeah, I know.
Oh my god, he's not coming. My Tinder date. Soz girl, Nuthead's not even in London. See ya, winky face. Oh. No, I can't take this. This was supposed to be my big night out, and now it's ruined.
Wait, he's not worth it. Let's go do a shot. The barman's promised me like five.
Well, that didn't take long, did it? Nothing. It's just so typical of you to be frantically pursuing all the attention you can desperately grasp.
Excuse me?
Like you would shrivel up and die without the male gaze.
Why are you saying this?
You're like the Wicked Witch from The Wizard of Oz. Oh, men aren't looking at me. Help me, Dorothy. I'm melting, melting!
You're so
evil. Forget it! I'm gonna go do some MDMA in the bathroom because I'm too depressed to educate you yet again.
How dare you? I came all the way here for you.
Oh, come on. You jumped at the offer. Probably hoping you might kill that baby with booze.
Oh,
anything to stop you from having to admit that you don't actually want
Why
it.
Why do I do this? Why do I put up with this? We're not even friends.
Don't be ridiculous.
No, we were Rose's friends and she's gone long ago, so why am I still here? I don't even like you.
I have no idea. Probably because you bored the shit out of your other friends. I mean, fuck, even Rose would bitch about you. Fuck you.
Bye. It's me.
I know that you said not to call or email, and I know that you probably don't want to see me, and that is completely understandable, but I think that you'd want me to be here, and I think that it's important because, well, what I'm really trying to say is, I found some of your pants, and I was thinking of throwing them out, but they're a nice pair, one of your nicer pairs, and I thought that you might be missing them. I haven't washed them, I didn't know if you wanted me to wash them, I can wash them for you if you want. So just pop round whenever I think that you've still got a key, you can pop round, or I could post them to you, or your sister. Or, you know, maybe one day we could meet up and I could give them to you in person. It's just they are a really nice pair of pants. Why do we even say that, do you know, like a pair of pants? Because it's not like there's two of them, it's not like they're socks. Anyway, that's why I'm here, and that's all I really wanted to say. I found your pants. And I still love you.